It's your ASMR friend, just checking in on you. I hope you're doing well. So, just look at that view. Look at all those stars. You can hear that fire. You can feel that breeze. Can kind of feel small, but that's not such a bad thing when you look at the stars this way. So, right now I'm in the middle of a mystery. And I doubt that you and I are going to solve it today. But that isn't the point right now. I wanted to show you. Because to me, this really shows how beautiful our universe is, how fragile it is, and how important time is. You see, for reasons I can't explain, I'm stuck in this 22-minute time loop, and I don't know why. At first, I was afraid of it, scared. But now I've embraced it. I come to my ship every day, or every 22 minutes. It's kind of hard to keep track of what time actually is anymore. As you can see, this is where my spacesuit goes. And all important items. Oxygen, first aid, bandages, some tools. And over here is where I keep my log. Luckily, I have this. As you can see, there's something that I'm trying to piece together. And again, I don't even know what that really is. But there's more to explore here. Perhaps we'll check that out. There's some more items. Here's my cockpit. Let's blast off. You can really feel that rumble, can't you? And here we are. Into outer space. On our way to Gabbro's Island. Which of course is located on this planet. Giants Deep. It's a strange planet. I'm going to put autopilot on to get to that point. I could try to describe it to you, but I think it's probably better if you just see for yourself. Pretty smooth flight so far, don't you think? We're making good progress. All right, let's go in. So, as you can see, this is a water planet, and the weather, to describe it, is like something out of a nightmare. These hurricanes never go away. At least, not that I have seen. And then this scary as all hell one. As you can see, there's lighting in there. There's something inside there. But if I try to go right through it, I'll never make it in there. There has to be another way to it. And perhaps we'll start to unravel more of this mystery. Suit on. So, it's not all water. There's some land, as you can see. Ghost matter detected nearby. Ghost matter is very bad, as you all know. There he is. I've asked this a bunch of times, but why not? What's up with this planet? He's been stuck here. Remember, when I was saying that time is important. Because here we are, back at the beginning of this loop. And I haven't learned anything much. Maybe we'll try to be a little quicker. I know that somehow all of these planets, including the one I'm on, is connected in deeper ways than I think anyone has ever imagined. This time loop is happening for a reason. It's happening to me for a reason. And I want to find out. Well, why not? If there's more to discover, right? Let's lift off. Make our way to Gravity Cannon. It's still a little scary, even to me. But on the other hand, been an incredible way to explore this universe. Oh, goodness. I need to repair. I don't like this place. Not a big fan of this place. But it does have some great views. Also, these giant asteroids of fire keep knocking into this planet, making it even more dangerous than it already is. But I almost wonder if I should even fear death at this point. This time loop has me questioning certain things. Oh, I made a mistake. That's a mistake. Oh. No, 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 no. We're going through the black hole. Oh, no, 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 no. Unless I can get out of it. Come on. Oh, God. Well, that's a black hole for you. At least I have a decent amount of fuel and a good amount of oxygen. We don't need to panic. I doubt we can make our ship in time or to do anything of value there. It's not so easy moving around in this thing. Well, now that's weird, isn't it? I've been here before. At least I'm pretty sure. Yeah. I'm telling you, it's all connected. Welcome to the White Hole Station. If you fell through the black hole by accident, don't worry. You aren't the first. This warp tower can return you to Brittle Howl. Brittle Howl. Brittle Hollow. Every warp tower is tuned to a specific astral body. A tower's warp can only be used during the brief window when the tower is aligned with the corresponding astral body. In this case, Brittle Owl. Hollow. You must be standing on the warp platform on the floor during this alignment to be warped. If you look up while the station is rotating, you can see the alignment happens when the astral body is directly overhead. There's giants deep in the distance. Obviously, this needs to go somewhere. Maybe over here? There are times when I don't even want to move, when this time warp business happens. I just want to stare at the stars. But something is happening, and it's happening for a reason. That's the only motivation that gets me going through this. To our friends on Brittle Hollow, I just warped here from the White Hole station on the other side of Brittle Hollow's black hole. Our design worked. We've successfully recreated warp travel. What do they mean, recreated? I don't know how close it is to Anand's original designs, but as long as what we've built works, then I'm delighted. I know we could do it. I knew we could do it. I don't think we have much time. Wait, this can't be correct. Clary, have you seen these readings? If they were accurate, they would violate casually. There must be an equipment error somewhere. I'm returning to the White Hole station. If you, Root, meet me there, we can run a full diagnostic and hopefully locate the problem. Don't tell Casavant. This is wonderful news. I can't wait to see the warp tower, although it's been a long time since I've jumped through the black hole. Hanging City. Here we go. Where's this? Desert planet. haven't been to a desert planet yet. A stark reminder, isn't it? The records you sent, Poke, and they appear to show Nami are arriving at the warp receiver on Brittle Hall slightly before departing from the White Alsage. I understand it's exceedingly odd, but Claire and I have tested and retested the equipment, and the result is the same every time someone warps. 3 minutes of oxygen. Notice how I'm not panicking. I've become accustomed to this. I wonder where that planet was that we were looking at. Was it over there? What's up here? Has anyone observed the phantom moon that sometimes greets us in the night sky? Your thoughts interest me. I'm interested in your playful moon. It is much like its violent friend, Hollow's Lantern. This moon isn't volcanic, to my aided eyes. Sometimes it leaves its friend Hollow's Lantern for night time. The nights the moon circles this planet appear random. It seems to travel as it likes. Imagine if there were two volcanic. And I imagine there'd be none of us left. Hypothesis. There can exist too much lava. I'd strongly prefer we test the null hypothesis. I compliment your eyes. How do you imagine it disappears? Hypothesis. Could it be a shift in the light spectrum? Suppose this moon is too shy to show us its face. wish I could find a way back to my ship. But perhaps there's more on this planet. That's pretty far, isn't it? Oh gosh. No. Another traveler. And oxygen. Found the escape pod. That's right. I hope so too. Well, that's not it, is it? Well, all right then. No fuel. Great. I don't think this will end well. Of oxygen. I want that on record. Well, here we are again. Back to the beginning. Sometimes it can be hard to go on. But I have to remind myself. It's happening for a reason. I just know it is. Didn't even get to check out the thing. As well. Try again, right? You know what I miss the most? Sleep. Yet somehow, I don't feel completely exhausted. But I wonder how much longer can I keep my sanity? Is there ever a way to figure out what's going on? And even if I do, is that going to fix something? Is that going to stop it? I simply do not know. So much for that autopilot. Crashing right into the sun. It's a pretty big mistake. Going into the black hole is not something I want to do. I'm becoming a little bit reckless. I think that I need to search for something not out in the universe, but within me. So I think for this loop, I am just going to lay here for a little bit and just let my mind calm down. You can stay here for a little while, but You should probably get some rest too. Time is important to you as well, and I know that. But yeah, you can stay here for a while. But I probably won't